It's a huge privilege to play for veterans like Frank Towers, who recalls that fateful day in September 1944 when he helped liberate my city.
We had this tremendous rat race across northern France and Belgium and up to Holland. We were the first American troops to set foot on the Dutch soil. We worked our way up to Maastricht. All the bridges were blown out, so we had some of the local people around in the area get boats, rowboats, fishing boats, and ferry our troops across the river, right about where André's home is today. And from there, we worked our way up into the city of Maastricht. And as we were coming in, the Germans were going out across the St. Servais Bridge. So by the time we got up into the Freithof area, the Germans were running. So when we got here, great jubilation. They were happy to see the Germans gone. Every time I go back to the Freithof, I have memories of having been there. Well, I feel quite pleased and honored for André to have invited me back here, because primarily I was one of his liberators of Maastricht.
And especially for the American veterans in the audience, such as Frank, I play a tribute to the Andrews sisters, a favorite of the Allied forces.
Tell me, is it getting
Throughout the war, music played a big part in boosting morale, and there's one person whose songs touched the hearts of so many. I'm going to see the Force's sweetheart herself. Born in 1917, she became the voice and the pinup for so many servicemen. Of course, it's Dame Vera Lynn.
It's such an honor for me, Dame Vera, to meet you.
To meet you too.
It's fantastic.